It's time for the Commissioner's Corner, an exclusive weekly conversation about Indiana high school sports with the Commissioner of the IHSAA, Paul Neidig. Now for an up-to-the-minute report about what's happening in the constantly changing world of high school sports, here's Coach Bob Lovell with Commissioner Paul Neidig.
Welcome back, everyone. We are so glad you're with us for our weekly conversation with the Commissioner of the IHSAA, Paul Neidig. Commissioner, week one of high school football in the books. It was a great night weather-wise, great night in terms of games, attendance, everything about it was just a wonderful way to start this season.
First of all, you know, week one, coaches, as we said last week, half the teams in the state are undefeated and half the teams in the state are defeated, you know. But they're all refocusing this week, and I was just looking at some of the matchups, and it's going to be another banner week of high school football across the state.
You and your staff had a board meeting earlier in the week. I'm curious, for those who don't understand, you and your staff sitting in Indianapolis, you don't make all the rules. So this isn't a member institution type of association where the membership makes its own rules and you carry out their wishes. And so I'm curious in terms of, you know, structure and what you can tell people, what a board meeting consists of and how agenda items actually get on that agenda for these meetings.
Yeah, Coach, and I appreciate the opportunity to talk about that because it is truly a membership organization. Schools, they're not required to be a member of this association. They choose to do so. They elect a board of directors from the membership that serve this organization. I mean, they have full authority to set bylaws and hire and fire me, of course. And then, you know, anything needs to be changed along the way, and it often does. After robust discussion and study, bylaws are changed, and that's what the way it works. And the other piece of this is any member school principal across our 410 school have the ability to author a bylaw for consideration of change with our board of directors. And so, you know, it's a system that's worked, obviously, since 1903, and I think it continues to work really well today. And, you know, we just left a board meeting earlier this week, and we've spent about almost 4 hours discussing different things around the state, from tournament financial reports to penalties assessed to tournament alignments. You know, we approved the one thing we did this week was approve the boys and girls basketball tournament for this upcoming year. And so we're already thinking about the winter coming up here and what the winter sports are going to look like. So, you know, it's just kind of a never ending process.
Right.
To, you know, and things change out there. Schools change, education changes, you know. Unfortunately, people also try to find ways to we'll just say, cheat the system a little bit in my world. That
right.
book is awful thick because we got people who haven't right. done the right thing along the way, try to right. gain an advantage. And, you know, but anyway, we'll keep chasing those things too.
One of the things you talked about was a record-breaking year at the gate, your box office receipts, your attendance was record-breaking also. It was a fantastic year in many ways for the association last year.
Attendance was up again, so, you know, we certainly went through COVID, and then we're saying, oh, is people going to come back? Well, they came back in record numbers, and then we even surpassed that this past year. You know, we sold about 28,000 more tickets this past year than we did the previous year across all of our sports, and so very pleased with that. But, you know, one thing I'm real pleased with, Coach, is this association for the member schools operation, we do not operate off of tax dollars. Everything that we do comes in through gate receipts and some sponsorship dollars, but the primary driver of this whole thing is we return a lot of money back to our member schools. You know, and annually this year specifically, we're going to turn back an additional $800,000 to the member schools. So the total amount that will be back to school distribution is going to be about $208 million this year. And that's money that our schools keep locally from tournament participation. And that doesn't happen anywhere but Indiana, you know. And so we're so pleased to be able to do that. And we want to be able to return those dollars. And it's specifically from tickets back to our member schools for their operations of their athletic departments.
Thanks for listening to The Commissioner's Corner with IHSAA Commissioner Paul Neidig and Coach Bob Lovell. And thank you for your continued support of the high schools in your community.